Hi, this is Danica, and in this video, we're gonna talk about the memberships. Now, if you're new here to this channel, I build WordPress membership sites, and in this series, we are checking out the BodyBoss theme, and I'm gonna walk you through the basics of it. So, if you have any question, like certain sections that you see in this video that you think you need help, please comment it down below, and I'll do my best to answer your question in my future videos. So, let's get started. Okay, so this is the membership list or members list of BodyBoss. By default, this is how it looks automatically. Now, the way this does is it creates a list for your members here. And as you can see, you could have like connect and then messaging button. And then there's some option here to, as an admin, you see this view as, and then I think you could, in my past video, I have showed you how to add some following like functionality. So there's two formats. So you could do a list view or a grid view. And of course you could do a search and you could do a filter. Now, if we check one of the members here, as you can see, there is a banner and that they could edit. They could upload their profile picture, and this is kind of like their nickname, when they have joined, and when was their like last activity. I could also click disconnect, and by clicking disconnect button, that means you're requesting like being a friend, similar to Facebook. So you could send a message and so on. Now, I'm an admin here, so everything is open, but this is going to be different from the members to members view. So if you require the members to be like, they need to be connected first before they could communicate with another, then that's gonna be how it will look. In the profile section, we have some details here and some default data in here. Now, these are things that I think I have played last time, so that's why you see. But by default, you will only, once you have installed your BodyBoss, you will only see this part. First name, last name, nickname. In the timeline, this is like the activity of this member. So you could see, like you could write something to this member, you could attach a photo and so on. And in my past videos, I've shared to you how you could add more attachment in here based on what you have enabled for your like members. In the connection tab, you could see that who are like the connection or friends of this member. And of course, which group is this member belong to. You could also see like photos that this member has uploaded, and there could be like albums in there as well. And then forums as well, you could see in here. But again, I'm an admin, so I see everything. So example, if we go here on the profiles on the back end, you could see here that this is the details that we see on the profile page. This one. So that's the default data. Now, in here, you could add, so in the default, like on the details, this one, you could also add some field, edit field set, and so on. So you could actually update this, but you could not remove this default 3 item. Though I believe you could hide this. So example, profile navigation. So this is what the similar navigation to this one. So it's exactly the same with the group that we did in the last video where we could adjust the profile navigation. But let me just check in the components and then settings and then profiles. So here you could see that you could uncheck some stuff. So display format, I only want, let's just say nickname. And then you could see here that once we have assigned the nickname as the display format, display name format, then we could hide the last name and first name. Now, this is depending on your setup, but I have done a setup where they don't want to show the first name and last name of their member. They want to protect their members' like contact details. So they only want to show the nickname. So with that functionality, you could like do this. And of course, you could set some avatar here, default, enable some gravatar if you want to, and so on. So all of the settings in the profile is available in this settings. I think we have showed, I've discussed this in my past videos, but this is where it you could set it up. You could also see that you could advance, enable advanced profile search in the members directory if I save this. So if I click here, so I could add some example. Let's just say I want to add, I'm not sure, I have some existing field here. So I'm just gonna add that and then add some label test and save. So if you have like added specific or additional fields to your profile, the one that we could set here, so we could use that field. So in here, just want to show it. So we could use the field that you've added here as an additional filter in the members here. So as you can see, it did showed up in there. So you just need to enable that advanced search. Okay, so the one that I have mentioned earlier where your member, like if you want your member to be connected first before they could message one another. So in the BodyBoss settings and then connection, here you could check this to require non-admin members to be connected before they could message each other. I think this is very important because you don't want just anyone messaging spam stuff to your like member list, right? There's also says here that connection request, so select which member should have access to send connection requests to other members based on. So as you can see here, it has some WordPress rule. You could also create some profile type. This is a BodyBoss thing, profile type. And it, since I'm using Memberium, it's also showing the membership. So it's very compatible. Depending on your rule, then it will follow that. So example here, WordPress rule, I want to make sure they are like maybe group leader only, and I wanna like make sure to enable that one. So I don't want subscriber to send connection to one another because maybe this I want the group leaders only to have that capability to maybe message their members. That's why I am enabling this. But again, if you want anyone to just like message one another, as long as you say here require non-admin members to be connected first, then I think it's also making your website private. So you could do a subscriber, you could also do check all of this if you want, and you could even do like specific and do stuff like that. Now, as part of the profile connection, you also need to make sure you check your messaging settings. So this three is connected. So you need to check here under settings and then BodyBoss settings, messaging. You need to actually also make sure this is set up properly so that it replicates the way that you have protected your members list and then the connection settings that you have set. So again, this is just a basic walkthrough of the members. I hope that covers the basic. I think based on the setups that I've done, those are the sections that I always like check, needed to check. Depending on how the members works, then I may need to work on several filters based on the search, depending on that. And sometimes I even need to create a separate directory using custom post type. So it really depends on your setup. But in terms of BodyBoss, this is the available functionality that they have, and so far I think it covers most of the things that a membership site or a community needs. So it allows your members to be private and not be like contacted with just anyone on the list. It allows to hide their first name and last name and just show their nickname and so on. So I think with this privacy, your members will appreciate that you have like enabled it. But again, it depends on your community, the type of service that you have offered to your members, and how you interact with your members as well. Now, before I end this video, I'm also gonna discuss next the notices. Okay, so notices in BodyBoss, it's like a simple like notification that you could show very quickly to your members, and you could even like remove that once it's done. Now, the way this works is, example, if I go to my newsfeed here, this is how it works at the top, and I think, yeah, it shows at the top. So as you can see, this is the notice that I have, and if I close this and then refresh, so it's no longer showing back. Now, that's the one that I created in here. So I could deactivate that if I think it's no longer needed. And example, if I add a new notice, I create like, let's just say maintenance. And then I publish that. And then I refresh. So as you can see, I now see that maintenance notice again. Now, I think this part is very useful, even if it's a simple functionality, because with this, you could like announce something, especially like server downtime or maybe maintenance, or maybe you have some hiccups on your backend that you want your members to be aware, and just any random like unexpected problems that based on my experience do happen. So you want to have this announcement thing enabled for your website. So in case you don't see the notices on your left side in the dashboard, you just need to make sure that in the components you enable the private messaging, and that should enable the notices on your left side. So I hope this video helps, and if you have any question, please comment it down below. The membership list for me is very like helpful, especially if you want to have that directory and also the notice functionality. If you have like, if you think something's missing, you may want to dive deeper on some sections on the membership, let me know and I'll try to include that in my future videos. But yeah, I appreciate your support, and if you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe and notification bell so that I get you notified whenever I post videos like this. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.